Hey guys, what's up? My name is Sonali, and today I'm going to be filming a little life update for you guys. I feel like I haven't been posting too much lately on my YouTube channel, and literally like the last half of last year, I posted twice a week. So I was definitely on my grind, and I honestly truly don't know what's happening to me, but I'll kind of explain a little bit of that later. And I also thought I would throw in a Q&A, so stay tuned for that. So if you're new to my channel, I go to the University of Central Florida and I'm a senior. So this is my last semester and that's kind of why everything is just going crazy and like I don't even know what's happening with my life because I'm this close to being in the real world and it is super terrifying and I just don't even know what to think. Like I feel like I'm in denial about getting like a real job. I have a bunch of jobs, I'll get into that. Actually, I guess we'll get into it now. So technically, this is a job. YouTube is a job. I mean, it takes time, and I feel like anything that takes time and you get a little bit of income out of it is a job in my mind. So technically, yes, this is one of my jobs. My second job is I am a freelancer for photography and videography, and I have been getting so many gigs lately and I don't even know how because usually I get all my photography gigs like at the end of the semester when it's grad season time, like people need grad photos, but I've been getting a lot of like video gigs especially, so I've been doing a lot of that recently, which is super exciting because obviously that's more to add to my portfolio, and each time I make a video, I feel like I just get better and better. The third job I have is that I'm an intern for the UCF social media team. And what I do there is I create content for their YouTube channel. So it's kind of like more student-based lifestyle content. That's what I like to call it. So you can go on UCF's YouTube channel and they have a playlist called The Campus Nights. And I took over that series, so that's what I do now there. And that's really fun because it's literally basically what I do for my YouTube channel. It's like planning out the content, reaching out to people and resources to collab with on campus, writing out like scripts and stuff like that. So it's definitely a job that I'm used to and I'm comfortable with. And I've been interning with them ever since last semester. So I'm just doing another semester of this internship. And last but not least, I just recently started my fourth job and that is working for the app called Zup. If you guys go to UCF, you probably know and you probably heard of Party Tutor. Well, they rebranded to Zup and it's still pretty much the same app. You get a bunch of discounts on cover, on restaurants, you get free food sometimes, and it's just a really great deal for $5 a month. So highly recommend getting that app because it saved me a lot of money. So I work for them as their digital content coordinator, and I've been having a lot of fun with that too because I've been playing around in After Effects more and making a whole bunch of videos for them. I recently just made a scavenger hunt video, which is like super fun. You should definitely go watch it. It's on their Instagram. So it's Zup_UCF. So long story short, I have four jobs right now and it is a little bit overwhelming because once I get off from my internship at UCF, I go and work for Zup. And then once I do that, I maybe do some freelance projects. And then once I do that, I, you know, edit videos for my own YouTube. So that is why I have not been posting lately because all of my jobs are editing videos. So you can kind of just like think about how burnt out I feel by the end of the day doing all those three jobs and then coming back to my YouTube channel doing the same thing that I've been doing all day. And not to say I don't love video editing because I 100% do. I literally have three videos that I have filmed, but I just cannot bring myself to edit it for my own YouTube channel because once I get home, I just want to go to sleep or I just want to maybe watch one Netflix show or watch YouTube videos or just like relax for like a second. I remember telling my mom and like my boyfriend, like, I don't want to get a job, like I don't want to do that, I don't want to like have a traditional job, I just don't want to work, like blah blah blah, I just want to like, you know, do anything else but work. And now I have four jobs, so that's interesting. I definitely think that if I put in all this work right now and give my full potential to each of these jobs that I will have like a good amount of experience to get a real job. So I'm pushing through. I'm also making money, so that's, you know, that's nice. So if you're wondering why I haven't been posting on YouTube, that's the exact reason. I just sometimes cannot bring myself to edit one more video at the end of the day, but I am going to try to make, like, you know, specific days to edit and just kind of like push through, because I do love like uploading to YouTube and I love filming and I love editing, but you know, I just do so much of it right now that it's just like I need a break. So I don't know if you guys can notice right now, but I do have sort of a lisp right now. It's not like horrible, it definitely was way worse, but the reason for that is that I got invisible trays. So I'm pretty much have Invisalign, but they're the off brand. It's the brand called Clear Correct. And I'm so excited, guys, because I have been literally looking at my past pictures where I just got my Invisalign off and my teeth were so straight. So basically I had Invisalign my senior year of high school. I got them off and then I got my wisdom teeth out maybe like 2 summers ago. And by that time they really like messed up my teeth and my teeth were just so crooked after my wisdom teeth came in. So I definitely wanted to get them fixed up a little bit just because I feel like teeth are really important to me and I want to have nice teeth. And honestly, if I had all the money in the world right now, I would go straight to getting veneers, because I definitely think that I want to do that, you know, later in life if I do have the money. But right now, I'm just gonna fix them with my invisible trays. So that is why I have a lisp right now. I have a video up on just like kind of talking about the process of getting them on. And I actually put in my second tray and it did not hurt as bad as the first one. So I think it'll be a smooth sailing process from here. I can already feel my teeth getting so much straighter. I think I have like more than a year to go, but I think it'll be worth it. So spring break is in less than, I don't even know, like 6 weeks or something like that. Me and my best friends are going on a cruise and I am a little bit nervous because I've never been on a cruise. I've literally been on every other transportation that you could possibly imagine, but not a cruise. I just remember growing up and my dad would always say like he never wanted to go on a cruise because he would feel like he was trapped. I kind of have that ingrained in my brain, so I'm a little bit nervous about that. And I don't even know how cruises work. I mean, luckily, like all of my best friends have gone on cruises before, so they can kind of like guide me through it. We're going on a Royal Caribbean cruise, and we're going on a Royal Caribbean cruise. So I think that's one of the nicer ones. Let me know in the comments if you guys have ever been on a Royal Caribbean cruise. I think that's pretty much all I have to catch you guys up on right now. Overall, my head is a little bit everywhere. I'm a little bit stressed because there's just so much coming up that I know it's gonna hit me right in the face, and I'm gonna be even more stressed about it when it comes. For instance, I'm filming my sorority's recruitment video and philanthropy video again, and then grad season, and I'm gonna get probably the most clients I've ever gotten because it is my like graduating class, so they're more likely to book with me, if that makes sense. Oh, I hope so. And then what else? I don't know. Well, finding a job, that's gonna be insane. But let's get straight into the Q&A. First question is, do you use any teeth whitening? Your teeth are so white. I don't really use teeth whitening stuff that often. If I do, it's just the off-brand whitening strips because, you know, I don't really wanna spend all that money on Crest, even though I love Crest, but I just can never bring myself to it. But I actually just got this whitening gel that came with my invisible trays. I personally don't think my teeth are like super white. I mean, I don't drink coffee really, so maybe that's why, but thank you. The next person said, I study the same major as you. Do you have an idea of where you want to work after? Okay. This question is like half of the questions that are in my Q&A. They're basically just asking what I want to do after college. Do I know where I want to work? All that jazz. And I have no idea. Literally have no idea. I mean, you guys probably have known this because I think I said it like a billion times in my other videos, but I don't know at all. Ryan is currently applying for like 100 billion jobs. Like, he's on his grind and I'm very proud of him. And my mentality is kind of to see where he gets a job and then apply where he gets the job. And you guys might think I'm crazy, but we have literally been dating for 6 years now, so I'm not that crazy. I know that like I want to spend, you know, the rest of my life with him, and I know I'm going to go wherever he goes because I don't really have anything like holding me back. Does that make sense? I don't know. So I'm kind of just waiting to see where he gets a job, and hopefully that'll be soon. And then I can start looking for jobs wherever he does. Our original plan was to move back to Atlanta, live at our parents' houses for like 2 years max, and save up money for like a house or something like that. But plans might change. And you know, I don't know. So it might be a new city. And I'm kind of like hoping for that just because I moved to Orlando, like not wanting to come here at all. Like I wanted to stay in Georgia, but I ended up loving it here. And I feel like I could love another city just as much. And I just feel like now is the time to like live somewhere else and maybe come back to Atlanta. So we don't really have a finalized plan, but plans could change, and yeah, I guess that's all I'm gonna say. The next person asked, what got you into photography and film? Honestly, I feel like YouTube got me into it because I would obviously film on a DSLR and then I would obviously go and edit in my iMovie or Final Cut. And then I would just slowly start to invest in more things for my own YouTube channel. And I kind of just thought like, oh, this could be fun to like actually kind of make your money back on those investments. I remember really getting into photography when I was a senior in high school because I did some senior pictures of some of my friends. They honestly turned out pretty well for like some of my first shoots. And then coming to college, I started a blog and I kind of just knew what I wanted for my photos. So that kind of gave me the eye for other people's photos. And then I went to become VP PR of my sorority. So that deals with public relations. And so that kind of got me into photography more, taking pictures of sisters, and then obviously filming for the recruitment video. I feel like all my experiences in college and high school kind of just led me to this. And I'm so thankful for that because I don't know what else I would be doing if I didn't like love this stuff. Someone asked, what age do you want kids? When I was younger, I wanted to be a young mom. Like I literally thought I was gonna have kids at 22. Guys, I am 22, that is insane. I'm like living in a sorority house, I'm still in college. I don't know why I ever thought that. And I remember telling my family that I wanted to be a young mom and they would like freak out. They would be like, no, that is not okay. Like you need to have a job, you need to have stable income. Like, and obviously growing up, like I kind of like realized that that's not, you know, realistic and practical. And honestly, like, I feel like I want to have kids way later in life, not way later, but like later in life, because I want to like focus on myself, focus on my career, focus on making that money, and then maybe like think about it. So I'm not 100% sure, but I definitely want to have kids by like 32 or like 30. I don't know. I feel like today's generation is so different too, because my mom had me and my sister at like 24 and 26, but I feel like it just keeps getting later and later. So who knows? Someone asked, did you always know what you wanted to major in before? If not, what made you realize? So actually I changed my major. I think it was like freshman year, so it wasn't that crazy. Like I didn't change it like my senior year. I was originally electronic journalism, and kind of my dream job at that time was being Juliana Rancic on E! Network. I was and I am obsessed with E! Network and just like entertainment hosting. I thought that's what I wanted to do, and I think that still could be like a really fun job. But then I started to realize like I don't really like journalism. So I switched to radio television, and then I just went the generalist track. You could have done production, which I probably should have because it seems a lot cooler, but I just went the generalist track. I feel like I've gotten most of my experience outside of the classroom. I'm gonna be honest, like I love school, I love UCF, and it's given me so many opportunities outside of the classroom. So I'm very thankful for that. This one says, where do you see your YouTube channel in the future? I don't know. I'm like struggling right now because I feel like y'all only click on my videos if it says college in it, and in a semester, I'm not gonna have that advantage to put like college in my title because that's just weird if I make college videos like after I'm in college. So I don't know what the hell I'm gonna do after college with my YouTube. I definitely wanna like vlog a lot more when I get home, like especially moving vlogs because I'm gonna be moving into my dad's and that's like not even decorated yet, so I have like all that to film for you guys, but literally after that I have no freaking idea. So if you guys have any ideas for like after college videos, like let me know in the comments because I'm stressing. This girl asked, what's your favorite thing about being a senior in college? I think what's so cool about being a senior is just having that like hopeful attitude about just like starting a new chapter in your life, like it's just like a whole different chapter. Like you're done with school, like at least for me, because I'm not doing grad school. Somebody asked, when are me and Ryan tying the knot? Again, when I was younger, I wanted to just do everything so young, and I thought I'd like be married by now, obviously, because I thought I would have kids at 22. So I probably would have been married before 22, which just doesn't make sense. I feel like I don't want to get married right out of college. I feel like there's so many reasons why I won't get into all that. I feel like I definitely want to wait like minimum 2 years after college, but I also don't want to wait like forever. So I guess it just all depends on Ryan. Next person asked, are you going to miss being in a sorority when you graduate? And 100% I'm going to miss it. I don't know what I'm going to do with myself, because I feel like this was such an easy way to make friends, because we all had this like common bond of being in the same sorority. So it's going to be like a little bit tough for me to make friends out of college, and I'm a little bit worried about that, because I feel like having girlfriends for me is a really important part of my life. And when I move back, I feel like I'm really only going to have Ryan and like a couple friends. But yeah, I'm a little worried about making friends after college. So next, I got a couple of questions about my religion. One said, what is your religion? And one said, would you consider yourself being religious? So I am Catholic. My dad's Hindu, but my mom and my dad raised me as Catholic. As much as I don't want to say this, I don't really consider myself religious. Like, I pray, you know, ever so often, but I don't really go to church, so I don't want to like lie to you guys and say I'm like super religious, but I definitely do believe in God, so. The next question is, what is your go-to drink at the bar? I would say anything with tequila in it. I really like tequila sours, tequila Sprite, like literally just anything with tequila in it. Usually I drink tequila like to pregame, so I like to like keep with it as the night goes on. My friend Kaylin asked me, are you gonna let your hair get really long again or keep it shorter? I don't know. I know like a lot of people like my hair when it was short, but I always like want it longer because of ponytails and just like curling it and styling it. I feel like it looks like so pretty long, but then there's just that line of like it being too long and like being healthy. I feel like I'm just gonna go through this like circle of my hair life all the time, like cutting it short, wanting it long, growing it long, cutting it short. I feel like I like the length right now. It's not like super short, it's not super long, so maybe I'll keep it like this, but I don't really feel like the need to get a haircut anytime soon. The next person asked, do you wonder what it would be like dating another guy because you've dated Ryan for so long? I just like wonder like how different my life would be sometimes, because I feel like Ryan has impacted my life so positively that I wonder like what a wreck I would be if I didn't have him in my life, you know? Like that's like, I feel like that's a little bit cliche, but like you guys don't understand. Like Ryan has been there through like everything. And I'll be completely honest with you guys, I feel like there's no other guy out there that can put up with all my shit. So I'm very, very, very thankful to have Ryan in my life. The last question of the Q&A is, in the future, where do you see yourself permanently living? I feel like even if we moved to a different city after college, we would definitely come back to Atlanta. Sometimes I think I'm a little bit biased because I have lived there my whole life. But then I think like so many people from the outside want to come to Atlanta. Like it's a cool city to be in, and there's just so many suburbs outside of it that are like really nice and safe and, you know, good to raise a family. I'm pretty sure my city, Roswell, is like top 10 of like the safest cities to live in. So I definitely think that we'd come back there. It's just that we kind of just want to experience something a little bit different for like a little bit. So I hope you guys enjoyed my life update. I hope you guys don't hate me for not posting as much as last semester, but it's all for good reason. I just need a little bit of a break sometimes. But I do want to get back on the grind. I'm going to try really, really hard, but if it doesn't happen, it's because I'm working a lot and I'm sorry. But I will see y'all in my next video. Bye!